Like the song goes, please let me introduce myself. I'm a man with little wealth and fame. I too have been around for a long, long time. I owned a company called Eastside Choppers back in the 70s. I was also president of a motorcycle club called Iron Wings. Maybe you know my name. And I had a television channel up in Boston. That was probably back in the 90s. 80s to 90s. Ran for about 10 years. You know my name? It was called Fat Bob. Now I'm just Bob. I now do most of my work here at my studio, my home studio. Here you can see some of my past airbrush work. That was my latest. That was my last. That was done maybe about a week ago. Well, with that said, oh, by the way, did I mention all, and I mean all, that all the work is subject to approval. My approval. I don't ask for any money up front, but I do ask that any and all parts submitted are clean, and in some cases, sandblasted.
Sandblasting is a really common process in today's day and age for removing surface rust, paint, and other debris from metal. Now, what we have here are two wind chimes. These are for a client. We are basically sandblasting them and preparing them for powder coating. Now, sandblasting is one of the best way to clean the surfaces, especially on these, because they're very odd in shape. They're not very easy to wire, wheel, or sand. So, sandblasting is the best alternative for the job. Dana's gonna demonstrate in a few moments. As the name implies, sandblasting uses an abrasive media, and what it does is it pulls it through an air gun and basically shoots it at your material at high velocity. It's almost like a moving wall of sandpaper. It gets into just about every nook and cranny and leaves a very clean surface.
You guys and dolls that can't bring in your gas tank or any other parts you may want my work done on, you can mail it to me at this address.